Huh? What the...
Any plan of attack? Plow right through him? I'll suck it up.
Can't stop not.
What can I say?
Oh, never too many stairs.
I got a bad feeling about this.
Stairs, they go on. Forever they go on. On and on and on.
He's gone.
Thing I need now.
Eyes peeled, mouth closed. See ya! Prompto's here!
Thanks.
Prompto! Yep!
Hell yeah!
Get your asses out of here, all of you!
No one miss your nice guy!
Rough day, Prince?
Nothing I can't handle.
Good. I'd be worried otherwise.
A place to cross, huh? We've come. Let's go.
Right.
Seems they don't want us to cross.
Well then, maybe we shouldn't. Opening.
Nice one, Prompto.
Good for nothing. Locked rules.
Hey,
weakness! Instructions!
That's crossing the line.
My hand slipped.
How's everyone?
Good.
How about you?
Just chipper.
It's a crossroads.
Which way?
Whichever way leads to the treasure.
If only we knew that.
Well, guess we bumble on.
Keep the bumbling to a minimum.
Let's do this.
Right.
Oh, and I was just getting warmed up.
Hey!
Let's keep moving.
Shall we?
Yeah.
The Empire's no exception.
Yeah, right on. Couldn't have said it better myself. spacious. They're so gonna be a big nasty here.
The bigger they are, the harder they fall.
That concludes our business here.
Say, Commodore.
Aranea.
You said the Empire uses demons to make weapons?
Listen, you've seen Magitek troopers, right?
MTs.
They're born from demons. in a lab.
Born from demons.
Darkness is coming. If I were you, I'd watch my princely ass. A kingly ass.
Will do.
Fresh air.
Congrats. That concludes your training. You've still got a hard path ahead. But don't let anyone tell you how to walk it.
You may have been hired under false pretenses, but your assistance was invaluable, all the same.
Tell me something I don't know. You can spare the pleasantries.
Take care walking your path, Aranea.
Oh, right. Thanks. I will. And I'll train you some more if our paths cross again. Oh, and before I forget, His Excellency instructed me to give you boys a ride back. If you need a lift, feel free to hop on.
Well, glad that's over with.
Noct, I have just received word from Cindy.
And?
We're to return to Lestalem. Her friend works as an engineer at the power plant. She'll take care of the Mithril.
Uh-huh. And that'll take care of our boat problem.
Once you're rested and ready, I suggest we hasten back to Lestalem. Make sure you're prepared.
Say goodbye to such a nice...
Everything in order?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Old girl could really use a car wash.
And then we'd best stop at the nearest petrol station. Let's go.
Hit it, Specs. Ready? Let's hit it. Everybody out. The hunt is on.
Bring it on.
You're headed to Lestalem, right? I'll take you there, but no further.
Got it.
So, ready to ship out?
You bet. Let's fly.
Hold on tight, boys.
Look at that!
A red ship.
Rise and shine, Prince Charming. We're here. Sounds like a spot of trouble's popped up at the power plant. Wish I could help, but I'm powerless to do anything I'm not ordered to. I'll leave the keeping of the peace to you.
Of course.
We got this.
Good luck, boys.
Loving that outfit, Noct.
Why don't you wear one?
Well, that's the only one. And if anyone stands a fighting chance in there, it's you. Forget about fashion and go.
Testing. Do you read me? Just wanted to thank you for offering to clear out those demons. That'll give me time to treat this Mithril for you. There's a hunter who went in right ahead of you. I imagine there are too many for one to handle. But two of you should be fine. And a little heads up, I'm getting some unstable readings from the generators inside. Too much power and the whole place could blow, so be quick.
Will do.
So, you my backup?
I thought we were partners.
Anyway, place is crawling with demons.
Wait a sec. You sound familiar.
Save the talk. We got hunting to do. Now, if we're done with the introductions, follow me. There they are. You ready to rumble?
Oh yeah. Disappoint.
When have I ever?
Keep it up.
Will do. Now, let's scram.
Great work in there. As promised, here's your Mithril. And, thank you for your hard work.
Sure.
Hey, big guy!
So the hunter who went on ahead...
The one and only. How you been, fellas?
Not bad. Whoa, someone did a number on you, though.
You should see the other guy. Anyway, I'm back, and better than ever.
Knocked? Glady? I can't believe it!
Hey, thanks for looking after her, Dustin.
So, Glady, did you apologize to Knocked for storming off like that?
He made it up to me in there.
The power plant? Oh, so you got your hands on some mithril. In that case, I'll go deliver it to Sid. You'll probably want to freshen up first anyway. Come and meet me in Kaim when you're ready.
Hey, buddy. Got a moment?
What is it?
I could use a little help restocking. It's low volume stuff, too small for wholesale. I ask my customers all the time. How it works is I tell you what I need and you bring it when you can. Simple, right? Take a look at our wares. See you later.
Huh.
Hey, what are you after this time? Hey, come again. Look at our wares. Pleasure doing business. I'll see you later. Hey, what are you after this time? Pleasure doing business. Hey, come again. Take a look at our wares. Pleasure doing business. I'll see you later. Time to go.
Mm-hmm. really looking forward to Iris's cooking.
I'll pretend I didn't hear that.
Aw, don't be that way. It's different when a girl cooks for you. Shot with the lighthouse, hair blowing in the breeze, we'll be seaside supermodels.
Seaside supermodels it is, then.
Oh yeah! Seaside supermodels!
Take a shot from here.
Good call. Now it's picture time. Ready or not? The gang's all here, see? Us?
Interesting toy you got there.
This? It's just something we picked up after taking out some Imperials.
Well, I'll be Crown City made. If you like, I can make this puppy better, give it more oomph.
How?
I can mod it for you.
Mod it?
Look, I got diddly squat to do what with Cindy taking care of the garage. If you can find the parts, I can do the work for you. There's a surprising amount of useful stuff lying around. Go s- Proceed with thanks. Y'all just leave the rest to me. Take it for a spin. It'll be a riot. Nice job finding this puppy. Well, y'all know the deal. Fix me up with parts. Fixing up, great. Whoa! Crown City weapons ain't designed with upgradability in mind. At least not their... Alright, y'all just sit tight while I do my tinkering. Here she is. Try her out and let me know what you think. How you fixing it? Stand up straight, boy. You slacking off.
Huh?
Prince Noctis. Even the Marshal came to say goodbye.
I guess it's goodbye for now.
Something I gotta get off my chest.
What's that?
I'm sorry. Sorry I wasn't there for your father. I swore an oath to protect the king, but I wasn't strong enough to uphold it.
Ain't nothing nobody could have done to stop what happened.
Yeah. I realize that.
But you need to realize just what you mean to the boys by your side.
I do.
Even if they can't solve your problems, you can't hide what's going on from them. It hurts like hell. Remember, those ain't your bodyguards. They're your brothers. Trust in them, always.
You can never have too many tools. Here, learn to wield not only weapons, but magic as well. Just remember, it's a destructive force that doesn't discriminate. I suggest putting someone in charge of it.
Waiting for an invitation? Get your asses on board!
Hey! Your Majesty!
What's up?
Please! Come back soon! We need our king!
Yeah! Count on it!
The wedding day arrives, but alas, without the bride. Of course, we've come for the Hydrian, and you've gone to such lengths to prepare.
Merely my duty.
Ah, but for an outsider to lead the Imperial Army must be a battle in and of itself. You've spoken to Lady Luna Freya.
No.
That obstinate secretary, standing in the way. while you rush off to slay the Hydrian for your poor sister's sake. I know the price of the Covenant.
You know, I've always wanted to go sailing like this.
Not many opportunities living in Insomnia.
Out here, it's just us and the horizon. It's amazing. It's life-changing.
We've quite a ways to go until we reach Ultisha, so keep gushing to your heart's content.
When we step off the boat, we'll be in a foreign country.
The anticipation alone is a foreign sensation.
Then to think this is where we were headed to begin with.
We've been through a lot.
And there's still more to come.
So next on the docket is Leviathan.
What sort of deity are we dealing with?
A serpent said to embody the roar and rage of the sea.
We'll have to see for ourselves.
Can't let Lady Luna Freya do all the heavy lifting. You must be so psyched to see her.
Luna?
Yeah.
Well, we need to make sure she's all right before anything else.
Indeed. Her well-being is top priority.
Don't like this going down on Imperial turf.
You think Lady Luna Freya's in danger there?
The Empire did invade Lucis for the ring. I have no faith their ruthless ambitions will stop short of harming the Oracle.
Without the ring, the crystal's no more than a rock.
I suppose. Does anyone know how Lady Luna Freya came to have the ring?
It seems likely His Majesty entrusted it to her safekeeping back at the Crown City.
So she's held onto it this whole time. All the way to Ultisha.
The ring is important, and so is Leviathan. But Luna comes first.
You know, I was thinking back to our encounter with Ravus. Do you recall an apparatus in place of his arm?
Yeah, I remember.
Seems he lost his old one in the invasion. But in its place, he seems to have acquired new power.
Power?
That would help explain how a son of Tenebrae suddenly came to command Niflheim's army.
Now that you mention it, his strength did seem sort of supernatural. I just chalked it up to the Oracle lineage.
His ancestry may be part of it, but that alone wouldn't account for his freakish strength.
I wonder what could have happened to him.
There's a disturbing rumor about. Lord Ravus has taken to brandishing His Majesty's sword.
My dad's.
Then what's the big idea behind that?
That his power's the same as the power of kings?
I cannot say for sure. But I have my doubts. Ravus wears the sword, yet doesn't wield it.
For all his newfound powers, he's still the Chancellor's lapdog, holding onto the enemy king's sword like some badge of honor.
It might help if we knew what he was after.
You can say.
What are the odds the Empire will crash the pool party with Leviathan?
Consider it a guarantee. They felled a god to prevent Nopt from receiving his blessing. They'll do so again.
But we beat him to the big guy. Thanks to our friendly guide.
Never know which way that one's gonna move next.
The Chancellor has an agenda all his own.
Sometimes it helps. Like when he called off his army and let us escape.
But he was still a creep about it.
Well, it feels like he's only helping us because he wants something. I just don't know what.
Reckon we'll see him again?
Certainly hope not.
Not your type?
No love lost for phonies.
As Gladio said, his actions are motivated not by altruism, but by self-interest. And when he does come to our aid, I see only condescension in his eyes.
Yeah, can't argue with that.
Ever think you think too much?
Sometimes, but it's always preferable to the alternative.
So, soon you'll have your old man's ring back.
Yeah, when we arrive in Ultisha.
Good thing. To him, it was his heritage.
Is that what my dad said?
Carrying a royal line ain't a task to be taken lightly. For a small thing, that ring can sure weigh heavy. After he became king, I only ever saw his face in the paper.
Wait, weren't you at the coronation?
No, I was long gone from the city.
Must have been invited, at least.
Had a falling out of sorts with your old man. Right at the end of the trip.
You did?
I was given to understand you stayed in touch.
We buried the hatchet years later, but never talked face to face again. Should have paid a visit while I had the chance. Well, no use dwelling on it now. Got the regalia in the hold, but you're all gonna stay in Alticia for a good while, right?
Yes, we believe so.
In that case, I'll tune her up for y'all. Not that I'll have much to do, though. Well, with Cindy looking after the old girl.
If you say she's good, she must be great.
She was never afraid of hard work. Heaven knows she had a hard childhood.
Hard childhood?
He means her parents.
Lost them both when she was little. It was big enough to understand, though. And to hurt. But you wouldn't guess that, seeing her now.
Not at all. She's always so cheerful.
Well, that ought to tell you how far she's come.
Now you must have seen your fair share of Alticia by now.
Yeah. Only done been the once. Stayed a good while, though.
What's it like?
Big old city.
Big. Okay.
Well, it ain't the Crown City.
Different. Got it.
You'll see for yourself. Foreign lands seldom lend themselves to trite explanations.
Change of scenery ought to do you good.
Well, I'm all talked out. Can't be far to Alticia now, right?
We'll be there in no time. Nice having the wind at our backs.
Lodgings are a first order of business.
All work and no play makes Ignis a dull boy.
Someone has to babysit me too.
Well, you're welcome to sleep in the wild.
Ain't no hotel, but I know a fella has a place.
Hey now.
Wescombe ran with Reggie and me way back when.
Oh, was he the other one in that photo with the garage?
Yep. Runs himself a diner or cafe or something. Go and see for yourselves.
Sure.
Does the place have a name?
McGee or Magoo or Mago. That's the one.
Nice.
You can count on old Wes, but he'll chew your ears off.
The government issued a statement promising that the reasons behind awakening the Hydrian would be clarified in the ceremonial address.
Got a signal!
Delivering the address will be Lady Luna Freya, who was previously reported dead. This will mark her first public appearance since the violence that befell the signing ceremony.
Lady Luna Freya's gonna give a speech?
Sounds like it.
Lord knows. This world could use some wisdom.
Won't be much longer now, Noct.
Yeah.